Joe Biden sent American jobs to China and other nations while the Bidens vacuum up. Now, look, did you see what's going on with his son? I mean, he goes into a country, the guy leaves with, like, volumes of money, vacuum up millions of dollars all over the globe. Last night, Joe lied straight to the American people. He claimed that he had never taken a penny from any foreign source ever in my life, ever. Now, I mean, he goes and think of it. His son without a job, knows nothing about energy. Have you, these young people in front, do you know anything about energy? No, she said no. She knows more than Hunter. Remember, where is Hunter? By the way, where the hell is Hunter? Where is Hunter? Remember the T-shirt? I said one time, where's Hunter? The next day they had a T-shirt, where's Hunter? There he is. Hunter, you gained weight. But you look even better. You still look better. Anyway, no, but think of it. He gets lined up with this Ukrainian energy company, not the highest reputation. 183,000 a month to be on the board, right? Gets a $3 million upfront payment. Then that's only First Nation. Then he goes, he has no knowledge of energy whatsoever. Anybody in this audience knows more. They then go to China. Let's go to China. He gets $1.5 billion to manage, meaning millions of dollars a year in fees. He then goes to Russia. He gets $3.5 million from the mayor of Moscow's wife. $3.5 million. And Obama was in charge of all of that stuff. Then they stole the Crimea. They stole the submarine port, Russia. And Russia takes it. And he's in charge of Russia, but he got $3.5 million. So what's going on with that? So he was in charge of Ukraine, China, Russia. That was sort of a responsibility of the vice president. And he got money from all of them. And he got it from his son. And his son made no money for years. And all of a sudden, he's making all this money. They're corrupt politicians, okay? You say what you want. And then you see the notes and you see the gentleman that got up yesterday and you see what he had to say. He's a legitimate person. But you see the notes and you see that Joe gets 10% of everything, right? And Pammy got 50% on something. And then the guy has a deal in China where he wants to get $10 million a year, $10 million a year for introductory purposes. In other words, he's going to introduce people. You know who's going to introduce his father? That's who he's going to introduce. No, it's a bad deal. It's a bad deal. It's corrupt as hell. I don't care what you say. It's corrupt as hell. Okay? And, you know, they like to also, they say, oh, well, what about you with the kids? I don't do deals. I used to do more deals. I was the king of deals. And I don't do deals. I tell my kids, you can't. It's conflicts. Just don't do it. So it's possibly allowed. It probably is allowed. But I said, we don't need it. Just don't do them. My kids, these kids have done such a good job. They have done such a good job. And they don't do deals. The Bidens got rich while America got robbed. And how did Biden get so wealthy spending a half a century in public office? He's been in public office for 47 years, almost 50 years. He used his office for personal profit at your expense, at my expense, at all of our expenses. In 2016, Florida voted to fire this depraved political establishment, and you elected an outsider as president who is finally putting America first and putting the villages first. Putting the villages first. We're putting the villages first. And if I don't sound like a typical Washington politician, it's because I'm not a politician. And if I don't always play by the rules of the Washington establishment, the deep state, the rhinos, you know, the rhinos are almost worse than our enemy. The rhinos, we love those rhinos, Republican in name only. You know what that is, right? Republican in name only. We got a lot of them. But they're slowly disappearing. It's amazing. They disappear into the woods. But if I don't always play by the rules of the Washington establishment. It's because I was elected to fight for you, and I fought for you harder than any president has ever fought for anybody. And with your vote, we'll continue to cut taxes. I got you the largest tax cut in the history of our country. Cut regulations, lower drug prices. Your drugs will be going down 60, 70, 80% because I'm instituting what's called the Favored Nations Clause. You see all the commercials the drug companies are running against me? It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. This is why I see politicians. This is one of the many reasons why. The other reason is that the biggest lobbyist, the biggest donator by far are the drug companies. Very powerful, a lot of money. They are taking commercials of me. I don't care. I'm doing the right thing. I instituted a Favored Nations Clause where the United States, right now, we pay the highest price of any country in the world by far. It's not even close. It's not even close. You could have a pill that sells for 10 cents identical, and in the United States could sell for $3. That's how bad it is. It's terrible. So I